I want to illustrate the laying out of a pipe system, providing data and doing an analysis, as illustrated by the quick start example, which starts on page 12 of your quick start guide. I'm going to follow the steps, starting with step one, that are illustrated there. The first thing we do is select a new file. We click on File, select New. Now it will ask me if we want to save this current file. I can say no. The first screen that appears is a new file specification, which allows us to define the important data, the units, which will take gallons per minute, and the type of head loss equation we're going to use, and we'll use Hayes and Williams. Some of these defaults for additional data won't really affect our problem, so we'll just accept the default that's shown and click OK. Now the screen will clear and we're ready to start laying out a new system. Now the first step is normally to provide a background, either import a background map or, as a minimum, turn on grids. We'll turn on some grids under map settings. We can select grids and turn on different scales of major and minor grids. We can use the ones that are shown, which are 100 foot for the minor and 1,000 foot for the major. Go back to the map and we'll see these grids. These are 1,000 foot grids with 100 foot minor grids in between. And we can start the layout of the system using these as guidelines. Since this system only extends about 500 feet across, I'd like to zoom in so I can get a little more precision. So I'll click on the zoom in button, and now we have about 500 feet to show. I can start anywhere I want. I just position the mouse and right click, and I'll lay out the first junction. And I can move the mouse to the next location and right click and lay out the next. I'm following the seven steps that are on the second page of the quick start example and laying out the system as shown. So I'm going to complete this layout. The last pipe comes off from here. I can select this and right click over here and add the last pipe. Now you'll note when you're done, you all have all the system is composed of junction nodes, intermediate nodes, and pipes. We have several reservoirs, so the next step is to change the junctions to reservoirs. You just left click on the node that you want to change, and then on the drop down list select the type of end node that you want, in this case a reservoir. And I'll do this for the second reservoir, select it, go to the drop down, select reservoir. Now the system is laid out as shown in figure 2 in the quick start example, and we're ready to provide data, which we will do in the next session.